good evening, kid. Welcome. We're the Missoula City Band, and look at the sweet Adelines are here with us through tonight. And I see some of you have already taken advantage of the pie. Please, get off your dead butts and sing the Star Spangled Banner with us, sweet Adelines. They tried to sing over top of us. You can probably hear them if you're in the first couple of rows. Oh, I'm so glad to see the clouds come in. That's why you're here tonight, besides the pie, because the clouds came in, huh? Oh, you cut the... Oh, look at that pie. Oh, man. Find me a fork, sucker. I'm afraid you're gonna run out of pie tonight. Hey, we've had some birthdays this week, and we got one coming up. You'd like to say happy birthday to some of our folks. Don Gisselbeck, who holds down the first trombone chair. Don, he's still just a young pup, but Don celebrates his birthday by skiing. All right, so he drives 3.5 hours, hikes 1.5 hours, gets to the top of Gash Creek, and it's about 15-second run. And he does that 2 or 3 times until he wakes up and gets enough sense to stop that crap. He's got brain damage. He also plays trombone, you notice? Sorry, Don. Also celebrating a birthday this week, but not as insanely, our head arranger, Mike Rosebarski. Mike's got enough sense now to go skiing at his advanced maturity. Our horn player's got Steve is like just a year younger than me. He's got a birthday coming up, or is it? No. Oh, it's yesterday. All in the past, these guys, and look, they lived another year, and a couple of birthdays coming up. Kurt Stavenbach is going to have a birthday coming up. What is it? Saturday. Yeah, baby, watch out. We'll be in the bitter end on Saturday, Kurt. And then, finally, to somebody in the audience, happy birthday to Melly Cooper. Here's happy birthday, kid. All the attention, all the spring babies, you know. We never get happy birthday for us. Hey, I have gone beyond my usual programming abilities to make sure that we've got the sublime with the ridiculous. Let's start with the ridiculous. All right, I heard somebody out there going, all right. That's right. I thought only in Montana could you marry your cousin and get away with it. Uh-uh. You can do that, was it Tennessee? Jerry Lee Lewis finally died this year after having married his 12-year-old cousin. Well, what a piano player and entertainer. In his honor, here is Great Balls of Fire. I'm sorry, Allie. From the ridiculous to the sublime, may I introduce to you Dr. Alyssa Powell, please? Yeah. We're so lucky the family is still here. So Allie and Novi come back and bring baby and visit, and I get to ask pathetically if we can do something together. It is not the clarinet polka anymore. For us old timers in the band, clarinet polka was years ago. So Ellie was a student of mine about 100 years ago, and she went on to do great things here at the university after Sentinel and then New Mexico. Then she went on to a school that will not be named and she's got a doctorate in clarinet performance. She's now teaching at University of Wisconsin Eau Claire. Oh my gosh. Dr. Powell, and then she married that crazy little student of mine from 100 years ago as well, Novi. And I thought too late to ask Novi to bring a saxophone along. He could have sat in with the band, the company. Hey, I will apologize for the mistakes I'll make in this beautiful tune. And when you think that things are getting weird, just focus in on Allie's sound, and everything will be okay. I'm willing to bet my clothes allowance on the fact that I bet you this piece has never been played in the city park. All right? I've been wrong before. Offenbach was not a contemporary of Sousa. I got caught on that one. But I bet you this is never. So it's available only on rental. It's a very serious work. Allie played it when she won the concerto competition at Ohio State University.
Oh.
And when she sent me the recording of her playing, it was like, oh, my God. And, of course, the outside movements are totally impossible and very, very sophisticated and academic. The middle movement is this beautiful jazz-inspired ballad. And so when things get strange, and they will get strange, just keep listening to Allie, and before you know it, it'll all come back together again. Yeah. This is the middle movement of William Bolcom's clarinet concerto, and Dr. Powell on the clarinet.
Thank you.
me. Got weird. I know I got lost one time. Oh man. I just heard that and I just kept playing it over and over again, hoping that I could play that with our band. We pulled it off. Thank you, Allie Baty. Oh my god. Okay, back to the ridiculous. Harry Belafonte died this year. So watch out. I'll be looking for some repercussions coming from the vocals and also from our wonderful collectors who's out picking your pockets. So if you're sitting on that rusty old wallet, dig it out. I'm not looking for folded over ones now, dang it. Here's a banana boat song. So long, huh? This guy's name was Gary Rosington, guitar player for the band. It's hard to pull off a rock and roll tune with a concert band. Alright, just hard. So just play along, okay? Here's Sweet Home Alabama. Thank you. You hear them tape boys taking stuff up an octave back there? Back to the bandstand, here's Allie, Powell. I could never keep her name straight, so back in the ninth grade, she came up with a limerick, and I remembered how to spell her name and her two renditions of it. She either went by Allie or Alyssa, and she came up with A-L-Y-S-S-A-A-L-L-I-E. I still remember it, Allie. I always misnamed her and spelled her damn name wrong and everything like that. Now I have to get used to saying Powell at the end. You owe me, Novi. She plays more notes on this palaka than I play in a lifetime. Get ready, hold on to your shorts. It just goes 100 miles an hour, and it's fun, and it's a sophisticated polka, is what it is. Written by Carl Maria von Weber. You sound pretty intelligent right there just for a moment, huh? And originally written, of course, for orchestra and clarinet, and it's just so much fun. It's not near as strange as that last one, okay? Here you go, man.
Thank you.
So it'd be a good time to go get yourself maybe that huckleberry pie you didn't pick the first time around. Burt Bacharach died this year, great songwriter, and this was made famous in his movie Butch Cassidy and the Sundance Kid. The name of the tune is Raindrops Keep Falling on My Head.
Thank you.
piece of pie? Sweet Adelines will be right with you.
You see her, and sometimes when she smells something,
thank you. Thank you. Yes, Donna Trousers and Gail Hall singing. They are called Flashback. Give me a hand, please.
Out of me, you turn the tables on me.
mosquitoes, you show up, and it allows us to be able to share this wonderful evening with you. And our final song is one of our favorites, and I think that you will find it a favorite too, because you've heard it before. Thank you, and have a wonderful evening.
Thank you, Candy and the sweet Adelines. Thank you so much, ladies. Hey, we'll see you next week. It's our last concert next week. Thank you, ladies. I'm going to get a blue sweater. Next week's our last concert. See you. We got all kinds of great stuff going on.